We're off to Colorado, 4:27 in the morning. Awesome. We've arrived, Rocky Mountain National Park. We are on the Grand Lake side at East Inlet. We're going to Adams Falls. Just a really short, easy hike into Adams Falls. Hiking up to the East Inlet Falls. I think we're about 3 miles in. Nice day, Friday, August the 12th. Storms aren't expected until maybe later today, or just iffy. That's the Grand Lake. That's the valley we came up out of. If you can see a green meadow right in that area. Headed down a non-marked trail. Trademark JB+K. I hear it, we see it, we're just wondering if we can get to it. We'd have to kind of go down to that stream and up and around, and we're not willing to do that today. A couple reasons. I have to go fishing, and it is 3:20. And we are seeing some non-ideal skies. Heard a little pop of thunder. That means head out. The clouds have provided a much relief on the heat. Although it's bright and sunny down in the meadow, which is where we will be fishing momentarily. Successful day. Found our waterfall, kinda, and caught some fish. I ended up with 6 brook trout today and some sore legs. I'm gonna pick that we eat chicken pesto pasta.
Well, ain't that a surprise? I knew that's the one we were gonna end up with.
You probably ruled that one out. All right, it's Saturday morning, 8:45 local time. We are on the North Inlet Trail today. We've got how many miles?
If we go fishing for the extra 4 miles, we're going to be around 15 miles today.
15 miles.
We're going to Cascade Falls, and we are going to fish 4 miles of North Inlet Creek above Cascade, because that's where the best fishing is.
We entered the part of the park where the forest fires were 2 years ago, as you can see. There's extensive damage throughout. All those trees are dead. All right, we're here at Cascade Falls. It's impressive. It's beautiful, and it just keeps going. V's. There's Jimmy V. He doesn't like V's. We're in the meadows above the Cascades. We got just a little bit of a jaunt to get back to the stream, and then we're gonna go fishing.
Got a cutty in the bag. Look at that.
One more down the foam, see if we can get this one. There he comes, right off the point, in the middle of the foam, right about there. Oops, the wind just picked up. That's not helpful. Oh, there he goes. He's on. It's a big one. Ta-da! Not bad for a one-man film crew. Boom, got that on video. Right in the middle of the foam. Foam is home. Well, we ran into a little squaller. A little swaller. We have hunkered down underneath the rock shelter. Shouldn't last long, maybe a half hour at the most.
We're tired. Pizza, here we come.
That was an adventure. Two rainstorms, hail, and we ended up seeing some moose. All right, it's Sunday morning, about 9:20. We have packed up our camp at Timber Creek because we have to move over to Moraine today. Before we do that, we are hiking Green Mountain up to the Big Meadow and see what we want to do from there. Here we go. We have reached the Big Meadow. Trail we were going to take to possibly hit those waterfalls or go fishing is closed due to the fire damage. So we're going to go back around to where we came from. And there's a little trail that goes out into the meadow that might take us to the river. Check it out.
So we are getting ready to filter our own water. We just used our last bit of water to try to make our meal, so we're going to filter some water. So we're sitting here at Tanahutu Creek on the stream. We are getting ready to have some lunch. We're having chili mac with beef today. All right, we are getting ready to unveil our chili mac with beans and beef. There it is. We're gonna let you know in a few minutes what it tastes like.
Add a little salt and pepper.
It's pretty good for a trail meal. Everybody who keeps saying this isn't home food.
Do you think it's compared to the pesto chicken? Better, worse, or about
the same? It's not as good as pesto chicken.
We're slugging through the middle of the meadow.
Gross.
Jimmy B just says, gross. know if it was, I don't know if it was better, but it was definitely faster. About 3:45, almost back to the car. Been raining on and off for probably about an hour, 2 hours probably. Nothing major, just a little bit here, a little bit there. Typical weather. Sun's popping back out. Verdict in.
I like it.
You like it. It's a success.
Monday morning, 6:41. It's supposed to rain today, so we are on the roll. Jimmy B has found us an adventureless program. we got a little bit of easy stuff today, hopefully, maybe kind of. So here we go.
Thousand Falls, 0.5 miles. Anything to say?
Good morning. Good Monday morning.
Oh, darn, I forgot my fishing rod. Oh, I don't need it.
It's gonna rain.
Fish are already wet.
My shoes are already wet. All right, so we didn't find Thousand Falls. It seemed like it was going to be more than we wanted to do as far as course and stuff, not length. So we are on a one-way, 9-mile road to Chasm Falls. We're committed to this road now, no getting off. So we're going to see what happens. Here we go.
Okay, we've arrived. Some rough hiking today. Adventureless Monday. So far, it's been an adventure. Been climbing around in the mud and the wet rainforest. But here we are. Nice, easy trail. Chasm Falls is over there somewhere. Arrived at the alluvial fan. This is where the Fern Lake Dam broke back in 1982 and flushed through the valley, knocked all these rocks around, and took out Horseshoe Falls down below. Alluvial fan. We are finding out what it means to be in the busy part of the park.
Santa Fe style rice and beans with chicken. We're getting ready to open it up. This is what it looks like. It looks very yummy. Getting ready to find out. Tastes really good. People are crazy when they're giving these reviews. I mean, maybe this wouldn't taste so great at home, but it tastes fabulous here out in the middle of nowhere. I like it.
Adventurous Monday just became Adventure Kingdom. We're on our way to Big Thompson River at the Fern Lake Trailhead. This looks familiar from the Big Minnow. Although there is a trail. And we're better prepared today because I got pants on. The only threat is we've been kind of expecting thunderstorms and rain any moment, so this is really close to the campground. So worst case is we'll just head back to the campground and go to Estes Park if it's a washout. Let's see how it goes. Back to Adventureless Monday. We got that dealing with it, and we both said we don't want to get pounded again for the third day. So we're gonna wait it out. It looked good. Saw the big trout. Broke off twice. It was awesome. But we're gonna give her a whirl later. Go back to sipping martinis or whatever Jimmy B wants to do on his vacation. Adventureless Monday. We went to the store. We got us a new stove because the other one was acting up weird. And we got us a... What else we get? A wading belt. That just goes around. I can put my net in because I was having all kinds of trouble with the Big Meadow.
Backpacks are the same, so yes. We got a backpack cover.
Mountain Smith, local company out of Boulder.
Yeah.
We will be reviewing all of this. None of this will be sponsored.
I got a hat.
And we got an outdoor research hat. One of my favorite brands is OR.
It's all wicking. Polyester.
Oh, look at that hair. Oh my God, what is it?
Wicking polyester. Knock you out.
This takes a while.
Well, because my ponytail's too high.
Wicking. This is the adventureless.
Polyester.
Look at that.
Quick dry. Can't wait because my head gets...
It's like a little kind of thing. It keeps your head from getting hot and like quick dry. So really cool.
Yeah.
We're back after an excursion to Estes Park where we purchased all of our gear. We are now back at Big Thompson River at Fern Lake, exactly where we were a couple hours ago. The reports are the fishing is tough. Let's see how it goes. That's a wrap for the Big Thompson. It was successful. Multiple bigger size brookies on the Tenkara level line double or tandem, where I had an emerger and a green nymph, like the nice little ranger told me, and it worked. I think I got probably one or two on the nymph and one or two on the emerger, so I couldn't really tell, and a couple of them fell off. But anyways, good day. It was a little wet and rainy again. The rain has really settled in, as you can tell behind me. But we're hiking out. We're going to end up going across this little bridge here and then go to the road and just hike the rest of the way to our car through the road to save ourselves a little bit of hassle. Jimmy B, as usual, was a trooper. She got an assist on at least one fish when I had some troubles with my net. But anyways, there she is.
Hey, I'm all geared up, dry. I had to wear a lot of clothes, but I'm good. It was fun.
Adventureless Monday turned into an awesome day on the river, as usual. Jimmy B had doubts, but I knew all along. We're going to go back to the campground, make some food, probably get in the tent because it's raining. Maybe play some cards. We'll see.
Yeah.
Tuesday morning. It rained on us a little bit last night. A little bit.
This mini match.
I had to batten down the hatches, literally. and we got wet. So what we thought we would do is whip out the brand new stove, and today is going to be breakfast. Who knew it? Let's get some gravy, and look at that, there's actually a bed. What I always want to do is grab one of these wet socks from last night. Clean down my handles. Biscuits are ready.
Oh my God. That's legit.
They're kind of hard.
Did you ever cook my biscuits? I told you 425.
You know what? You're lucky you got a damn biscuit. I already licked my fingers. It's good. Drop two damn pieces of sausage on the table.
Well, we're at Fern Lake and it continues to rain. We got our rain gear on. Our wet shoes. It's awesome. But we're gonna do this, maybe. This is just to get to the trailhead. We've arrived at Arch Rock. Next stop is the footbridge across the Big Thompson River. There's the Big T, roaring after all the rains. Spruce Creek. This is Fern Creek. It is absolutely dark. There's so much mud here. Just literally right over there where you see maybe Jimmy B coming up the trail is spruce, clear. And then just 30, 40 yards away, muddy. Fern Falls is clogged. A lot of trees have come down. Lake. We are doing chicken teriyaki rice.
Not my favorite one so far, but it's not bad.
Fern Lake was successful. Caught 3 Colorado trout, cut throats, and now we're headed up to Odessa, which is 3/4 of a mile up. Odessa Lake does not disappoint. Little Matterhorn. So we're back many hours later, the Spruce Creek Falls, and it's running clear. Are you crazy? 8:33, dark.
Good morning. It is Wednesday morning, and we're getting ready to try the Peak Breakfast Scramble. It's really good.
About a mile and a half, 2 miles in. This is the Glacier Gorge Trail.
So we have reached the lock. It is beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Look at that.
We have lunch in the prettiest places. Today is Mexican quinoa from Good to Go Main Food. And we're gonna have the premium chunk white chicken from Tyson. All right, we're in. We gotta wait 15 minutes, hang out, and then contemplate the universe is what the bag says. If you're gonna contemplate the universe, this is as good a place as any. The universe has been contemplated.
Good.
First fish in Icy Brook on the first cast.
Red hot. Heading out. We're at lock now. Just fished the lock. Fished Icy Brook. Caught a fish. And we think we fished Glacier Creek just below the little, looked like water flow station. And caught a couple down there. So that's that. Off we go to try to beat the daylight. Beat the dark, not the daylight. We want daylight. Well, we made it out to Glacier Basin Trailhead, Glacier River Trailhead. But we couldn't get a parking spot there this morning. That's one of the more popular ones, obviously. So we had to park down the road quite a distance. So we're gonna be walking the road, dodging cars. Prospect Canyon to the right. No fishing in Bear Lake, therefore it sucks. Day six, and this is our first fire. It's not busy. Thursday morning, this is our last day of hiking. We got Copeland Falls, Calypso Cascades, Uzel Falls. Don't think we're gonna go to the lake, because we got some fishing to do. I think there's two Copeland Falls, upper and lower. Uzel looks like it's gonna be the best of the falls. We're gonna fish the St. Vrain and
Coney Creek,
hopefully above Calypso, is where the greenbacks are. Let's see what we can do. Here we go. Upper Copeland Falls. This is North St. Vrain River Falls. It's beautiful. They say that the water is flowing much more than it has normally at this time of year. Home style chicken and rice. And this is our view. Water's boiling, you know what that means. Time to put it in. Yum. Might be the best ever. Okay, we're back where we started. Looks like it was about 6 1/3 miles, something like that. So really cool, we had some great waterfalls and we caught some fish. And just a few minutes ago, Jimmy B caught a fish after she took the pole out of my hand.
Yeah.
And we're gonna go out here to our car.
Our flight out tomorrow out of Colorado is really early, so we're both kind of sad, but we do have this beautiful scenery to exit on. Look at those mountains one last time. So pretty.
Friday. I can't wait to go home and be away from vacation so I don't have to get up so early in the morning. It is 5:29 Denver time. Flight's at 8:30. We gotta roll. I actually have a bed.
We are going to the time warp tunnel.
Headed to the natty. What up?
And that's what I've had to deal with all week long.
We're in the natty.
Actually, we're in Northern Kentucky. We're almost back to where we started. 82 degrees here in Cincinnati at 600 feet. Or I think it's actually 300 and some feet.
300 feet. Yes.
That's like almost 2 miles lower than what we were even a day and a half ago.
Need a ride, honey? Rocky Mountain.